Why did I get accidentally unsubscribed? And how do I undo it? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is a question I got earlier today. A valued vendor communicates order confirmations and billings to me via my email. The vendor now tells me that I unsubscribed, so he can't reach me by email. I don't remember unsubscribing, but must have. How does one undo an inadvertent unsubscribe? Actually, inadvertent unsubscribes can happen several ways, and I'm going to walk through what some of those are. Most of them are in your control, but a few of them aren't. And I want to be clear that whether or not these different ways apply depend both on the service sending the newsletter or using the email list and your own email service provider on which you are receiving email. Those two can cooperate and sometimes they don't. So the number one way people get accidentally unsubscribed, by marking something as spam. If you've signed up to an email list and you're getting emails regularly, and then one of them you end up marking as spam, either intentionally or accidentally, the email service that is sending that mailing list may decide to interpret that as an unsubscribe. The thinking is that if you think their email is spam, then you probably don't want any more. And of course, every mark as spam is a mark against that provider. So rather than risking you marking even more issues as spam, they just unsubscribe you. Now, your email service can sometimes try to be helpful. Your email service, the service on which you are receiving your email, may proactively mark something as spam on your behalf before you ever see it, and in such a way that you never see it. Your email provider's spam filter may stop email that is to it so obviously spam that it removes it from even making it to your inbox or your spam folder. Now, if your email provider uses, among other things, the industry standard hidden unsubscribe header, that then can be the same thing as having hit the spam button yourself, as we talked about above. The email gets treated as spam, and as a result, you're unsubscribed from that list, and you never see any of this happening. And unfortunately, there's no real way to tell when this is happening. So what it means for an email service to think that something is so obviously spam that it can basically get in the way of you seeing the message ever is unclear. It's probably a combination of some of their preset rules as well as the "this is spam" button on every other user on that system, if it's a shared email system like Gmail or Outlook.com. Now, it could be the email list provider being cautious. This is what I consider to be kind of like a catch. It's not as common as it once was, but it is something worth knowing about. And that is, if you mark something as spam that comes from an email list provider, and you are subscribed to other email lists provided by that same provider, they may take you off of all the lists if you mark even one of them as spam. Here's the scenario. You subscribe to a newsletter and you confirm your subscription. That means you've indicated that you really, honestly, truly want the newsletter. You later mark that newsletter as spam. So the newsletter service, of course, unsubscribes you from that newsletter, as I talked about earlier. But it then also unsubscribes you from other newsletter that you might get that come from that same service. Why? Because by marking a legitimate email, something you've explicitly asked for and confirmed as spam rather than unsubscribing, the provider might feel that they can't trust you anymore they can't trust you not to do the same thing to those other newsletters as well. If you were to do that, that would negatively and inappropriately affect their reputation and deliverability. Now, like I said, my understanding is that this spam for one, unsubscribe for all technique is pretty rare, but it happens. Now, not opening your email can actually factor into this. I'm told, but have not experienced it myself, that some email services, the email services on which you are reading your email, will monitor whether or not you open the emails for each mailing list. If you don't open one for long enough, or your security and or ad blocking tools prevent the open notification from being sent, your email service may proactively unsubscribe you, taking your lack of opens as a lack of interest. At the other end of what I call that conversation is the newsletter sender's side, my side as a newsletter provider. I can absolutely confirm that mailing list senders like myself will do what's called list cleaning, which also unsubscribes anyone who hasn't opened our email within a certain period. What's called an open rate is a very important aspect of mailing lists' deliverability, and removing those who never open a message improves that metric. That makes it less likely that the email will be delivered to the spam folder for all the remaining subscribers. And yes, I do this myself for Confident Computing every spring. I call it spring cleaning. Now, there's one that we think about from time to time that I think a lot of people overlook. If you were to forward one of these newsletters or email list mails to a friend, or to anyone for that matter, it will also contain the unsubscribe link down at the bottom of the message. If your friend then clicks that unsubscribe link, you are unsubscribed. Now, I know this works for my list provider, AWeber, because I do it. I will sometimes get replies to my newsletter saying, please unsubscribe me, even though they could do it themselves. What do? Well, I look at their reply. I scroll to the bottom because it includes the entire newsletter. And at the bottom of the newsletter is the unsubscribe link. I just click it for them. If you accidentally click the unsubscribe link yourself, of course, you'll be unsubscribed. Normally, that's pretty obvious, as you'll be taken to some kind of sorry to see you go kind of page, or are you sure you want to unsubscribe kind of thing. Basically, list senders really don't want you to unsubscribe if you're paying attention to what they're sending at all. But of course, it's obvious, or should be obvious, if you click the link yourself. There's a class of tools, I call them email overwhelm tools. I suspect they go by a lot of different names, but I know a lot of people feel overwhelmed by the flow of email into their inbox. These tools promise to reduce your email load by unsubscribing you from newsletters you no longer appear to care about. Now, I'm not a huge fan of these services because it just seems like the chances of getting it wrong are so high. For example, I could easily see them mistaking a business relationship using a mailing list to communicate as something to be unsubscribed from, where that's not what you want at all. Okay, so we've got a lot of reasons why this might happen, some of which are obvious, some of which are not, some of which are in your control, some of which are not. What do you do? Honestly, there's not a whole lot you can do, but fortunately, that not a whole lot is usually pretty simple. For most newsletters, including my own, if you find you've gotten unsubscribed, resubscribe. Just go find the subscribe form that you used when you first signed up to that newsletter and sign up again. In a business context, it's a little less clear, and that actually applies to some of the things that I sell on my site. You'll be placed on a different list, and if you unsubscribe for that list, I won't be able to contact you anymore about those products. In those cases, you probably need to contact the business and explain that you didn't really intend to unsubscribe and you want to be put back on the list. Sometimes, though not always, they can tell when and how you unsubscribed, And that could be useful information to potentially avoid the problem again in the future. So, bottom line, if you find yourself unsubscribed from something you want, resubscribe. If it's a business, yeah, you may need to reach out. And of course, pay attention to the unsubscribe links in your emails and never mark as spam something that you explicitly signed up for. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/174498. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.